Hope everybody out there is doing well. I just want to do a quick reminder of this thing that we're in right now, this pandemic, this epidemic. You know, years ago in 1929, there was Black Wall Street. There were Black people, you know, we owned stuff, we had stuff, and the elite didn't like that, right? So they set this bomb through, literally dropped fire bombs from the sky. Closed everything down, shut up shop, right? Because we were climbing a little bit too fast. Herbert Hoover was under, we were under Herbert Hoover's guidance and presidency at that time. People wanted to blame him. Those who defended him didn't want to blame him. They wanted to blame the prior presidency. Well, the prior presidency at that time was Coolidge. Coolidge was also a Republican. So still under Republican rule, we nosedived. Now, we can fast forward, and 87, Ronald Reagan, we know that was the crack epidemic. That epidemic was placed in only certain areas at the time, and we plummeted. We nosedived. He's also Republican. Happened again in 91 under George H.W., stock market crash. 08 hit people hard. Boom, swiped them out, right? Lost jobs, lost homes. But because we all sit at the table together and eat at Benihana, for some reason the country forgets these things. Now we're in a global epidemic, right? Our president was just beefing with China, ironically, last year. You guys can read about that. I won't bore you with the details. But now we're in a pandemic again, global pandemic. So I just want to remind you guys that this is always this political, economical roller coaster, right? Up, down, up, down. The party that cares for people and the party that doesn't really give a fuck. They're willing to sacrifice a few for the many. With that being said, there's too many people fearing the design, right? The design, by design, I mean the Titanic. The Titanic was designed to hold 1,000, but they only built the Titanic in case something happened, if the ship sank. They only built 800 takeaway boats, lifeboats, to save only 800. Did they care about the 200? No. It's always built by design to sacrifice the few, right? To guarantee the whole. And this time, just like the Titanic, they don't care about them. That's the muscle. The muscle is who makes the ship go. It's the blood, the sweat, the tears. They're expendable. So right now, what you want to do with your family is try not to be expendable. You don't want to be just the muscle. You don't want to be the blood, sweat, and tears. You want to get yourself and your family in an economical, financial position to get on one of those 800 boats. When I say this, I'm saying, yes, there's going to be people that get sacrificed. Yes, this is very serious, right? An explosion is serious. It's a fire. It's a real fire. Real people are getting hurt. Real people get burned. However, while that's all going on, y'all just got to make sure you watching the small print. You trying to, once the ashes and the fire and the smoke clears, you got to know and pay attention to what's in, behind the fire, to what's behind the smoke. Because we always get so sidetracked with all these smoke and mirrors. Now this, I'm not taking anything away from it. It's dangerous. It's real. I'm not slighting the coronavirus one bit. What I am saying is that someone sent me a newspaper that had the headline news of Kobe Bryant on the front. And in the small print to the left, it was a rush for the coronavirus vaccine. Small print to the left, right? But we were so focused on Kobe and his family and the tragedy that happened till we didn't see the small print. And a lot of times that's what happens in this country is a big explosion happens and we miss what's going on in the small print. So just stay aware, stay safe, wash your hands, you know, stay in the house, stay safe, keep your family safe. That way when the ship sinks, you can survive it and your family can survive it. So definitely follow the guidelines, but also keep your eyes open to what else may be going on. Because see, every time something like this happens, this is when after the explosion is over, we wake up and say, oh my God, go to the DMV and have to pay $200 for your sticker. And you go, wait a minute, when the hell did that happen? Oh, that happened in 2020 when we was all rushing to buy toilet paper. Then you go, oh my God, when did this math change? Oh my God, when did this change? How about 911 when people was grieving, they slid something under the rug? Oh my God, when did this take place? I didn't know this had happened. How about 08? When people was drowning and they lost their homes and four motor companies shut down and people, family suffered tremendously. That's when it happened. So in travesty, this country has a habit of sweeping, of sneaking something else in there that we don't know about. So keep your eyes open. It's ironic, I find it, that for some reason or another, every single giant, right, store is wiped out right now. Can you imagine the billions that have been made because everyone, they kicked these checks out, right? And we know who the big checks got kicked out to. We know the economic financial group who gets these certain amount of checks. And right when they get them, you have to go back to these giants and spend it on what? On toilet paper, on Lysol, on all this to knock you down. So every time that the country is growing as a whole, and you get a little too close to the big man, a little too close to that elite, they gonna throw a fireball, baby. The only thing you need to do is make sure you're not one of the sacrificial lambs, because they're gonna hit, the explosion comes. It comes like clockwork. This is what they do. So stop being surprised by the design of the ship, and baby, make your boat, make your canoe, so that way that you're prepared with everything, because it's going to come again. We're going to get past this like we do, and something else is going to come. It's important to teach your children's children that this is the way of the country, and the country is globally networked and all linked together. So now this one is just hitting worldwide. To my faith walkers, baby, we already know it's always a higher reasoning behind all of this. God has a plan. The casino, the whole strip is shut down. There's people that have lost their homes, lost their minds, lost their life, right? Their wives and their whole life commit suicide because of gambling, because they've lost everything in those casinos. So it's a reason, you know, that things need to be still to survive. So there's chaos. Chaos is needed, right? And calm and stillness is also needed. Finally, I want to thank, and you know what? A lot of people were calling me about what to eat. I go to school, shout out to all the graduates, but I go to school with a lot of younger people, of course, and they're calling me and asking what to eat. I'm gonna tell you, pizza. If you have to eat out, my suggestion is pizza, because it's going in an oven. It's about 500 degrees hot, going straight into a box. But none of that. I'm not going to name the places, but you know where they have open food and they're just grabbing lettuce, grabbing tomatoes, scooping rice, and it just stays open throughout the entire day, give or take a new batch here or there. Stay away from those places, you know, because that's where germs travel when there's no type of virus going on. But I just want you guys to be cautious of the coronavirus, but be aware of the governmental virus. Baby, it comes on attack in any way, shape, or form, and you got to be prepared for it at one point. But finally, thank you to all my sanitation workers, all my hospital workers, all of you guys that's working hard to get this thing under control, who's checking in people from the front of the hospital to the back of the hospital to the parking lot. God bless you and your families, and thank you for covering us and covering the country in this time. Stay safe, and what about the New World Order? Baby, we are the New World Order. Alexa, play.